Should you buy the Sony A7 III or the Sony A7 R3? Well, the answer is the Sony A7. Nah, you really thought I'd give that away that quick? Nah, I'm not gonna do that. First off, I just wanna say welcome to the channel. I hope you enjoy the content. And if you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, then you might wanna consider doing that. All right. Let's talk about the cameras. The Sony A7 III is a full-frame mirrorless camera with a 24-megapixel sensor that Sony is offering for $1,998. And the Sony A7 R3 is also a full-frame mirrorless camera, but it does have a 42-megapixel sensor and it currently costs $2,798. There is quite a bit of a price difference between the two cameras, and I got both of these cameras, so I thought I'd share with you why I think one of these cameras is slightly better than the other camera. Both cameras has the same design and housing and basically the same functions as well, except for a few things that are setting them apart. The mode wheel on the Sony A7 R3 has three custom modes that you can use, and it also has this like small button in the middle of the mode wheel that you actually have to press down to change the mode on your camera. The A7 III only has two custom modes that you can use, and it doesn't have this button in the middle, so you can actually like switch the mode without having to press down the button. And I kind of like that more, because usually when I'm switching the mode, I want to switch the mode, because I've never actually switched the mode without the intention of switching the mode. The A7 R3 also has a better viewfinder than the other camera, but since I'm personally like only using the screen when I'm shooting, I don't really care about the viewfinder. But of course, if you want the best viewfinder, then the A7 R3 is the way to go. Apparently, the weather sealing is supposed to be better on the Sony A7 R3 than on the A7 III, but personally, I don't use my cameras in any harsh weather, because that is like, I don't want to risk any of these cameras to break, because that is way too much money to repair. Initially, I bought the Sony A7 III because I wanted to have the highest megapixel sensor in a full-frame mirrorless camera that I could buy. And the reason for that is because I personally am one of those dudes that want to have the best tools at my disposal. And if I'm not satisfied with the content that I'm producing, then all I can do is blame myself and not the actual gear that I'm using. And my main uses was going to be like vlogging, portrait photography, product shots, and event films. Yes, I know, the A7 R3 is not a vlogging camera, but neither is the 1DX Mark II, right? And we all know a famous YouTuber that is vlogging with a 1DX Mark II. So the only reason that I bought the Sony A7 III is because my A7 R3 broke and I had to send it off to repair. And I had some planned jobs that I had to do, so I needed a backup camera. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't have bought it at all. When it comes to the autofocus on these cameras, both cameras are really, really fast if you are using Sony's native lenses. But if you don't want to push out the incredible amount of money that the Sony lenses is costing, then you can buy the Tamron 2875 and get all the goodness that native lenses also has, like the AAF and face recognition and stuff like that. The A7 III has 693 focus points and the A7 R3 only has 399. To be completely honest, I haven't seen any difference at all when I have been working with these two cameras. But for the sake of this video, I had to do an autofocus test, and as we can see, the Sony A7 III is just a tad faster than the Sony A7 R3. But both cameras are really, really good, and I actually can't tell any difference in the autofocus if I don't put them side by side like we just did. When it comes to the image quality of these two cameras, the Sony A7 R3 is a clear winner. There's no discussion about that. The insane resolution of that sensor will make your images like, oh, you will get these really detailed images, especially when you are like posting them to websites or social medias, when you have to resize this huge image down to this like smaller image that will fit on the screen. Another thing that is awesome when you have this insane amount of megapixels is that you can actually redo your composition in post-production without losing too much resolution to your final image. The 42 megapixel sensor will also help you to like hide the noise when you are shooting at really high ISO levels. And the reason for that is because you usually have to resize your images before you are posting them online or delivering them to your clients. So the noise level is not going to be as apparent because you're resizing that photo. To be completely honest, having that resolution isn't something that you will probably miss if you are buying the Sony a7 III. I mean, 24 megapixels is actually more than enough for most paid jobs. And it will be a really good performer in low light because the pixels are actually bigger than the a7 R3, so it will allow your camera to like absorb more light to your sensor. And another thing that I noticed on the Sony a7 R3 is that it actually has Face AF in 4K mode. That is something that the a7 III doesn't have. I've been using the a7 III to record most of my videos here on YouTube for the last month, and the image quality is like, it is insane. The difference between the two cameras is like, it is barely noticeable, but the a7 R3 is like, it is slightly better because of that high resolution sensor just scaling down the image. Both of these cameras are like super packed with technology, and they are probably going to last for some years to come. You don't have to worry about missing out on anything if you are like thinking about buying one of these cameras close to when this video was actually posted. So if I had to decide between these two cameras, I would actually go for the a7 R3, but I would not recommend you to buy an a7 R3, and here's why. The a7 R3 is a fantastic camera in so many ways, but the a7 III is also a fantastic camera to a better price. And the money in between that you have to pay to get up to the a7 R3 is not actually worth it for the functions that you get. And that is, of course, if you don't really need the big sensor. So if you're thinking about buying one of these cameras, then I would go with the Sony a7 III and take that money that you will actually save by not buying the R3 and invest that money into a really good lens, like the Sony 70-200 f4, for example, or something like similar to it. But again, if you are a gearhead like me and you want the absolute best image performance that a camera in this price range can produce, then you should go with the a7 R3. Please do drop a comment below. I would love to hear your thoughts on this and why you chose one camera over the other. Make sure to hit that subscribe button if you like this video, and don't forget to give it a thumbs up as well. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Until next time, take care. Yeah. What do you think? Is it good? I actually went to the barber like before I recorded this video. You know, you gotta look nice for the YouTube videos. Yeah. Anyway, thank you so much for watching all the way until the end of this video. And yeah, you rock. See ya.